All right, what's up, Hawk Sports fans? We're finally back here with another video for you guys. Shout out to Dana for getting two UFC events in the Midwest / Southeast in the last 3 weeks. We're here at UFC Louisville tonight. Huge card, 14 fights. It's going to be crazy in there tonight. I'm very excited. First time in 13 years Louisville's got this event. So I'm excited to bring this to you guys. Hopefully see some really good finishes tonight. We're here with Logan. Logan, what do you got for us tonight?
I have no idea.
He doesn't know right now, but we're about to mess around and find out. So we'll see you guys inside. It's going to be an awesome, awesome night. Hope you guys enjoy it. Smash that like button. Subscribe. Here we go. So we made it to the seats. They're pretty sick. We're not as close as we were in St. Louis, but these seats are a little elevated, so we kind of see more of the octagon. I like the seats a lot. I'm not going to talk too much from here. Very excited for the fights. We should have a really competitive main event tonight. Should be some high-level striking. So we'll see you guys in 30 minutes for the first fight. It's going to be a banger. We got a full card of 14 fights coming your way. Here we go.
Yeah. They don't know, they give him a good chance to.
Yeah, man.
He was defending, he was out there.
By TKO, Zachary Southern! Dominant, the devastating. Tori, how long do you want us to see?
Slick and Lowe's.
All right, guys, that's going to do it for UFC Fight Night Louisville. I didn't want to film leaving Louisville. It's just so crazy. Once again, I just want to say I'm so blessed for the opportunity to be able to attend two of those events in a month span. That's, you know, somebody that has to sit at home a lot of the times and watch these pay-per-views, and, you know, it's in all these places all over the world. But, to, you know, even just to be able to go to two fight nights within a month time, that's very, very incredible. So I'm very thankful for the opportunity to go see those in person, and, you know, to bring this, you know, live to you guys. I love vlogging for you guys. I love making the best content possible. We're going to keep pushing these videos out. TikTok has been booming lately. The YouTube short reels have been booming lately. So if you guys have been here since day one and you're still watching this video, I really appreciate you. And if you're new to this channel, we're just going to keep busting out sporting events for you guys. Keep going. I mean, I love all sports, especially UFC. So just to kind of recap the card, though, first five fights were pretty bad. I'm not going to lie. I was snooze fest in there. After that, it became pretty, pretty live. Every single fight on the main card minus the first one, so five of the six had a finish. A little upset with how the night ended, though. My guy, Dustin Jacoby, got finished pretty quickly against Dominic Reyes. I'm happy for the guy, though. You know, he's lost four in a row, arguably beat John Jones. So, I mean, good for him, but, you know, I'm also just really, really upset. You know, I like Dustin a lot. I think he's a really good competitor, and he just got the short end of the stick on a few things that haven't went his way in the UFC. So I know Dustin's going to jump back in there and get after it, though. He's a really, really high competitor. As far as for that main event, I mean, if you're watching that live, Cannonier's career is almost pretty much over now, with Herzog making that decision to step in there and not really give him a chance to go out on his shield. Me personally, you know, Jared Cannonier is 40 years old. This is probably his last chance at a title run, with him being the number four ranked guy and Sean Strickland sitting there waiting for the winner of Izzy and Duplessis. So really, really unfortunate. That was probably one of the worst stoppages I've ever seen in my life, and it just happened to be at one of the events I was at. So I respect Jason Herzog a lot. I really do think he's a good ref, but that was just bad. You know, Cannonier still had his hands up. I know that he was getting hit with a lot of shots there very quickly. He was backing up. He was even running at one point, but at that point, you got to let him go out on a shield or at least go up. I mean, he wasn't even against the fence whenever it got stopped right there. It was out in the open too, so very, very questionable there from Herzog. But also, just to kind of note the fact too, they just posted it like 15 minutes ago whenever I got back. That was the highest gate in UFC history for a fight night. So I've now been to the number one highest grossing gate in UFC history and number two for fight night. So Louisville, then St. Louis. The game just continues to grow. I don't know why people don't watch this, especially this time of year with basketball and hockey wrapping up professionally. You really just got the MLB on and then the WNBA, and outside of that, it's pretty much it other than college baseball going on. So it's where it's at. If you're new to the sport, get in on it. It's a really, really fun time. But just want to say a quick shout out to you guys. I've really been busting my butt lately to try to bring new content, try to post on all platforms so everybody can see this. So let's just continue to grow this and see how far it goes. We'll see you guys next time on Hawk Sports. We got a vlog coming on Tuesday when Paul Skeens will hit the mound for the Pittsburgh Pirates against the Cardinals in St. Louis. We will see you guys there. Have a great evening. Thank you for tuning in. We'll see you guys next time on Hawk Sports. Peace out.